that, Father, we know that. Whatever we say in thanksgiving. Lord, we thank you for the family, first family. We thank you, Jesus. Father, you are still faithful. This wonderful moment. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for the first time. We now are left in the name of the clothes. I send the voice of the Lord. Facebook, Mena kai tsumlani, bula tsi wai zona kalou. Kotsiova na matanga ni sile niko. Masulaka na sombo na matanga ni sile niko. Na maka na kalou mena tanga tanga mana. Waraka na kalou. Hena matanga ni sinda, veke tona tsi wai jane. Masulaka na vale lotu, masulaka na balongo. Masulaka na koro na buka. Sora tami tu niko, so tami tu na nende. Tami tu na uli manua. Rodando como o senhor do Nakai de Nebua, Luke do Atom Sangamuru Kabitu, Kerema Natura Mataka Nikua, Mendo Tala Mataka Bau, Beba Kanon na Bosta, Baba Bona na Lama na Bem Mataka, Mendo Mataka Bau, Mataka Nisiga Nikua, Pegata na Baki Lakina, Ligo Lama Mai na Tobu Mata, Lama Mai na Bata, Lama Mai na Sunday Nipule Sanga no Dono, Likua Baki Lana Kaloma na Takoso, Hena Mataka Nisiga Nikua. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Masulaka, masulaka na sombo na kalo. Masulaka na bosa ni kalo. Masulaka na tukuni yalo. Masulaka.
Your presence this morning. The truth of your words is two or three are gathered in your names. You are in the midst. Father, we thank you for this morning, wonderful morning, to come and serve you. To run up in our level and so on in the Tubaka. Some you, some must like it and we came to run up. And a bullet in Bagabota. But so Tabukin and Dona Bullet of our wrong mind. We came up in the Tinolomani, Sare, Church of Tanikua. To run up a Boston Narata, don't talk in the Nathamuni. Bona ni mami masu ni mami turanga. Masu seka sana na yada tani. E na yada ngani ni mami ni ko tisu na ni mami turanga. Tisu na ni mami vagabula. Amen. Bona ni mami sana mara turanga. E na matanga ni sila ni kuwa. O biki ta bagu biki ta na matanga ni sila ni dai. E na yada tani ni mami turanga o tisu Kristo. Praise the Lord, eh? Biki ta bagu biki ta na jari church members na matanga ni kuwa. Biki ta bagu biki ta tu na lami one zone na matanga ni kuwa. Biki ta bagu biki ta na matanga ni kuwa. Victor Bagrana, Manana Talin, Moneturana, O Jesus Cristo, Ena Matane Sinicua. Will you remember the Victor Sunday? You have a lot to my, you have a lot to my, don't get the Senate of Minaka, you get the Bob in the Tunaka, the Mona Minaka, several of the Sabo Sau. Hallelujah.
Come on, come on. Jesus, amém.
let us come together as we worship God this morning. Let us prepare our heart to listen to the word of God, to listen to God speaking to you this morning. Let us prepare our heart, worship Him, might, Tolomai, worship, hallelujah, hallelujah. And we thank you, Father God, for this morning.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father, that you speak to us.
Thank you, Lord.
We glorify your name.
Hallelujah.
We magnify your name, Lord. Thank you that you speak to us today through revelation. Oh, we thank you, Father God. We praise you. We magnify your name. Hallelujah. We glorify your name, Lord. A beautiful morning such as this. Then we can come together, hallelujah, and worship you. We magnify your name, Lord. Speak through the week, the mountains that we go through. Hallelujah. Glorify your name. We magnify your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Worship you this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let us sing together. Let us worship together. Hallelujah. When two or three gathered in my name. Let us pray and let us sing to the Lord as we worship Him this morning. This is the time
For you and God, this is the time that you approach the throne of God with worship. Hallelujah. From your lips, from your hands. Hallelujah. Ukarasha darabahaku. Ikarabashi kiriya sakaraba. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Oh, we worship. We call the spirit of worship into this place, into this sanctuary. Fill up this place with the spirit of worship, humbleness, and humility. We thank you, Father God, as we come here this morning. It's not about the church. It's not about the day. It's not about the time. It's about you and you alone, Lord. We are here to worship you, Lord. We are here to worship you. We are here to worship you, Lord. Oh, we thank you. We praise you, Jesus. We glorify your name. We glorify your name. We magnify your name. You are the rose of Sharon. You are the lily of the valley. You are the bright morning star. Oh, you are the tribes in the, you are the lion in the tribes of Judah. You're supposed to be exalted. Oh, to be praised among people. And we thank you, Father God. Oh, we praise your mighty name, Lord. We glorify. Oh, we will never get tired of praising your name. As the sun rises to the sunset, from the morning to the evening, we'll continue to worship you. Hallelujah. We'll continue to worship you. We magnify your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, Rashatara Mamakura. Ikarama Shikiriya Shandara. Oh, Rashatara Mamakura. Mebakazere de Re. Hallelujah. Urashatara Mamakura Shikiriya. Worship you this morning. Come on, church. Let us worship you. Let us come with a heart of humbleness. Let us prepare ourselves. Oh,
Spirit. bring heaven down to this sanctuary. We'll all sing together for the last time.
What a wonderful topic today, Holy Spirit and me.
Tapi kita boleh tukar mata kan di sini kuat untuk tukar dengan utama. Ya lo tamu pada kita ikan daru.
Hallelujah. And I believe this is the one of the most important topic in the church today.
Gondor utama bibi, gondor metode tukar nama di sini semua lo tu di kuat.
Because the Holy Spirit is the very reason why we here.
Ya lo tamu dah bunuh gondor itu di kuat, era bunongo.
Jesus normally talks about heaven.
Jesus had to go to heaven.
Going to heaven.
Hallelujah.
But the Holy Spirit's duty to come and help us
here.
Jesus is the way to
heaven. The
Holy Spirit is to be with you every day of
your life.
Hallelujah. You need to understand
that.
That Jesus physically is sitting on the right hand side of God.
The Bible says
that. Hallelujah. Do you know that? That Jesus is sitting on the right hand side of God. So if God is sitting here, Jesus is sitting on the right hand side.
Hallelujah.
And he is the control of the King of heaven. And he said, it is good for you for me to go. Hallelujah. Because when I go, then the Holy Spirit will come. So the Holy Spirit's duty is to be with you in this life. Jesus is waiting for you when you die. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I hope we understand that.
Eh?
We were not taught with that. That the Holy Spirit is with you. That's why we're living a life that is very indisciplined. Because you don't know that the Holy Spirit is with you. Hallelujah. Whatever you say, the Holy Spirit
hear.
Amen.
Amen.
Whatever you see, the Holy Spirit is seeing. Praise the Lord. Then that's why you need to understand the function of the Holy Spirit in our life. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus said, I have the authority.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Authority. Hallelujah. The authority of anything is in
Jesus.
That's
why he said in Matthew chapter 28, verse 18, all the authority from heaven and on earth is given to me.
Hallelujah.
Now he said, go and wait for the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit comes, then you shall receive power. Power to what? To live this life. To live this life. To live with the drunkard. To live with the adulterers. To live with the idolaters. To live with the sinful people. To live with the wicked people. The Holy Spirit will give you the power to live this life. Hallelujah. Because without the Holy Spirit, then we will be always attached to sinful life. Galatians 5:16, the Bible says, you must walk with the Spirit, so you don't do the desire of the flesh. Hallelujah. Without the Holy Spirit, we'll continue to do what the world is doing. With the Holy Spirit, we have the authority and power to walk away from the lust of the flesh. Hallelujah. That's why our best friend is the Holy Spirit. Tell your neighbor, Holy Spirit and me. Tell your neighbor, Holy Spirit and me. So let us go to this teaching, and I believe there's a lot of things that we can deprive from this teaching today. Let us read together. Hallelujah. When you sit in the Bible study like this, sit like you in the classroom. Don't sit like you in the church. Because it's easy for us when we come to church, we just listen and listen. We don't take note. We don't worry about the test. Hallelujah. That's why a lot of people, when you hear, but you can't hear.
Hallelujah.
But when you sit in the classroom, you hear maths. You hear chemistry. You hear physics. You hear English. You understand. And when the examination comes, most of us sitting here, we are about 50. But when we sit in the church, we hear. If we are exempt, maybe 5%,
10%.
So don't sit here like sitting in the church. This is the Bible study. It's not preaching, Bible study. Hallelujah. So when I say read, let us read loud. We read together because this is a Bible study.
Amen.
Amen? Amen. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you are in a classroom at the moment. My Ruah Tolu. The Holy Spirit is God Himself, or the working power of God, and can only be described as the third person in the Trinity, one God in three: God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit was present as mentioned throughout the Scripture. So not only when Jesus said, it's good for you for me to go for the Holy Spirit to come. No, he was mentioned right across the Bible. Okay, let us go to some scriptures. Number one, Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. From there we already know that the Holy Spirit exists. Let us read the English on top, and then we read together the Fijian with Tartalga Shivuli at the bottom. 2:3. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Hallelujah. When we talk about the Holy Spirit, not only during Jesus' time, no, is there from the beginning. It's not something that just happened after Jesus. That's why the Bible says, let us make man in our image and our likeness. One God, but present in three. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Not three God, one God. Not three atu, one atu. One you can see, one is my mind, you cannot see. One is my heart, you cannot see. One person, three. Three in one person. Because we are created, you and me, we were created to be like God. That's why we can present ourselves, our mind, our heart, our body. The food that you eat only feed the physical, the one that you see. The word feed the both the mind and the heart. And if you continue to eat the food of this world, and you don't eat the word of God, your one side will be growing up. And two-thirds will not grow. That's why your mind will always like a child, very childish. And your spiritual strength will not be growing. Because you are only eating the bread.
But in your
all the physical things. When Jesus said, man does not live on bread alone. We need the bread to your body. We need the word to your mind and your heart. I hope you understand the three in one that I'm talking about. Some people say, Christians, they worship three gods. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. No, no. One God presented in three places. Turn to your neighbor, then tell your neighbor, now I realize that you are three in one. Let us move on. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Also in 1 Samuel chapter 19, verse 20. Let us read together. 2-3. Then Saul sent messengers to take David. And when they saw the group of prophets prophesying, and Samuel standing as leader over them, the Spirit of God came upon the messengers of Saul, and they also prophesied.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Spirit of God again came in. And so many, I'm just picking a few that presented to us this morning. Another one, hallelujah. John 1, 32 to 34, 2-3. And John bore witness saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and he remained upon him. I did not know him, but he who sent me to baptize with water said to me, upon whom you see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, this is he who baptized with the Holy Spirit. And I have seen and testified that this is the Son of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This is John witnessing to us.
That
God spoke to John, the one that the Holy Spirit will come and rest upon. That's the one that will baptize with the Holy Spirit. And if you look through all our logo, the Holy Spirit represents fire. The fire represents the Holy Spirit. You look at one of the logo on the wall. Hallelujah. Taltala baptized you with water. Like Taltala John. Like Taltala Atu. Like Taltala Mesa. We baptize you with water. But Jesus baptized you with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So when you believe in Jesus, remember there is a tendency that he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. And sometimes you will do the unexpected. Unexpected. Because it's no longer you, it's the Holy Spirit in you. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus said, When the Holy Spirit comes, you become my witness. You will be my witness in Jerusalem. You will be my witness in
Samaria.
You will be my witness in Judea. And you will be my witness to the rest of the world. Any nation, any country you go to, you become a witness of Jesus. Holy Spirit and me.
Hallelujah.
Okay, let's read in Ephesians 2:3. Asa tukuna ko choni kakaya. Awari dan ay alok tambo di sala ko sumu bayo malagi mebekana rube. Asa may toko bua. Ya kawase ng ikila iko ya ilusi. I don't know him. They were in Jordan. So Jesus was among the crowd. Then the Holy Spirit come like a dove. Only John saw them. Nobody else saw them. But God already spoke to John. The one that you baptized, the one that I'll send, the one behind you, is the one that I'll send the Holy Spirit, not only on him, will be in him. Hallelujah. Let us continue. 2:3. Ia kukwe sa talayaw may mubi papitishtaki and away sa kaya miyaw. So, okay, let us read together. Ia kukwe, rotolo. Ia kukwe sa talayaw. O diya? O diya talichon? Yeah. So God is sending John. Jesus is physical. Sa peritika muna nona ministry. Ni hoti na papitishtaki. After this baptism, then Jesus started with the ministry. He was 30 years old. So only Mary know about Jesus at that time. Only who? Because Gabriel spoke to him, you will get pregnant and then. So that means when they go to Cana in Galilee, when Mary said, the wine is finished. She knew from the time that she was born, to the time the angel spoke to her, there must be some miracles that are not written in the Bible. And that's why she said, Jesus, the wine is finished. And Jesus said, why you tell me? I got nothing to do with this. My time is not yet come. So Mary, only Mary, apart from everybody else, only Mary know that Jesus is called by God.
Mary don't know my kila.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So ia kokoe essa taleia mai ili batarotolu. Ia kokoe essa taleia mai meu bim papitejo taki en wai. Sa kai nga viau o koe ko na rei de ni sa la ko so bukina na elo tabu. Asa mai toko boa se koe o ngo sa bim papitejo taki en elo tabu. Ia ko a rei da ka tukuna ni se koe o ngo na lube ni klo. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Okay, let us move on. We were just talking about the Holy Spirit for us to understand that it was from the beginning, right across the Old Testament, now in the New Testament, the beginning of the New Testament.
Say
with me,
Holy Spirit
and me. Tell your neighbor, Holy Spirit and me. Kailake. O yalo tambu batake yao. This is the connection that you should not lose. You can lose all your friends in the world, but don't lose your connection with the Holy Spirit. Some people say, if you change your church, you go to AOG, you go to New Methodist, you go to Pentecostal, you'll no longer become our family. You rather severe that relationship, but don't severe your relationship with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Now, number one, we're talking about Holy Spirit. Number one, the prime role of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. When you go through this first lesson, this one of the lesson, Holy Spirit me, number one, His role. Not Netanyahu, his role. Let us read it, taken from John 16, 7 to 15. Ruah Tolu. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Helper will not come to you, but if I depart, I will send him to you. And when he has come, he will convict the world of sin, and of righteousness, and of judgment. Of sin because they do not believe me. Of righteousness because I go to my Father and you see me no more. And of judgment because of the ruler of this world is already judged. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. Hallelujah. Jesus said, I have a lot of things to tell you, but you will not understand now. That's why the Holy Spirit is coming. Huh? Hallelujah. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth, for he will not speak of his own authority. But whatever he hears, he speaks. He hears from who? Whatever he hears, what does it mean? Whatever he hears between God the Son, God the Father, whatever he hears, will show it to you.
Amen.
That's why the Bible says, the Holy Spirit knows the deep things of God and reveal it to you.
Amen. The Bible says,
so Jesus was telling the disciple, when I go, this is what the Holy Spirit will do.
Praise the Lord.
The Helper, the Comforter, will go through the names that is mentioned in the Bible. However, when he, Holy Spirit, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. He'll guide you into all truth. For he will not speak of his own authority, but whatever he hears, he speaks. And he will tell you things to come. He will glorify me. Whenever you glorify Jesus, whenever you say, Jesus is Lord, that means the work of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That's his work. He will never talk about himself. He does not want us to continue to uplift him. His duty is to tell us to uplift who? Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And I want to get into the way of the Holy Spirit, we welcome you. Thabagaika. Question, you mean I got to come back there in the rain? When I'm not sure, I'm going to come back there in the rain. Jesus. And he tell you things to come. He will glorify me. What's with Jesus? For he will take what is mine and declare to you my miracle, my power, my authority.
Praise the Lord.
I cast out demons. He'll never talk about him. He'll always talk about me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So now we're going to because the name is Jesus. The name is Jesus. The name that we should exalt is Jesus. Okay, let us go to the Fijian. Hallelujah. Let us read from the colon. Nisa second nivosa taki koya. Rua tolu. Nina second nivosa bakataki koya. Ia ena kake denga ena romoda ena mosataka. Kana bakataki la vi kemudo na vika ena yado may muri. Ena baka roko roko taki yao po koya. Nina kauta na nongu kaka bakataki la vi kemudo. Sa nongu kake denga sa nintamangu. A kaongo kausa kaya kina. Nina kauto ko kwa na nungu ka. Kapagata kila abe ki mundo. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Are you with me this morning?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So number one. This is how the Holy Spirit works. He will convict the world of sin. Remember the first lesson. We are on the first lesson.
Amen.
What is prime role? Prime role. What is prime role? Hallelujah. So how can he reveal to us his duty? Number one, he will convict the world of sin. John 16:7-9, 2, 3. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world of sin, and of righteousness, and of judgment. Three things that he will come and do. Number one, we are on the number one. Say me number one. Okay, let us read the Ephesians. 2, 3. Iyan isara ko may kukoya, and magatakila kime ihira na kay murura, na iwaroga, na nondono, kay nalawa. Hallelujah. That is the duty of the Holy Spirit, to convict you of sin. When people do sinful life and they don't repent or feel bad, that means they lose their connection with the Holy Spirit. Either you are far away, or whether you are very hard and heart or stiff-necked. Praise the Lord. Because that is duty, to convict the world. Who is the world? You and me. Hallelujah. So whenever you do something and you feel bad, that's good. That means the Holy Spirit still communicate with you.
Hallelujah.
And if you do sinful life and there is no conviction at all, that means the Holy Spirit cannot reach you in telegraph or mobile or email. He cannot reach you.
Go
to church on Sunday and go back and sing. Another Sunday go to church. Monday and Saturday go and sing. No conviction at all. Praise the Lord. But when you do something and there is a conviction, that means your platform, your network with the Holy Spirit is 4 bars or 5 bars or 6 bars. You're not perfect, you'll fall along the way. But the Holy Spirit, that's why the Holy Spirit will pick you up and challenge you. Stand up. It's not the end of the road. It's only the beginning. You fall 10 times, you stand up 11 times. You fall 100 times, you stand up 101 times. And that is the work of the Holy Spirit. Oh, slap your neighbor and tell your neighbor, when you fall, rise again. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Because nobody here, including me and Taltala, nobody here is perfect in the eyes of God. We all fall short from the glory of God. It is the work of the Holy Spirit to convict us to stand up and to better our lives and to improve our lives from glory to glory, from mountain to mountain, from power to power. It's the work of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay, let us read John 14:25-26, 2, 3. Ao sabor está cada vez calmo, bom e quebrado. Niu sati com bata que quebrado. E a natão de vivo a devoi na ela tabu. Cocoia é talame com tamangu. É na lagu. É na boa bolha de quebrado. É na caquela na cau sabor se que na vez quebrado. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
Hallelujah.
That you have a teacher all the time. You know, in school, the teacher is only when you come into the classroom. But this teacher is with you all the time. Whether you are eating, whether you are driving, you travel by bus, or you sit in a taxi, you go by train, or you go by plane, you in a hall, or you in your house, or you in a church, even in a workplace, your teacher is always there to teach you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So the Holy Spirit will tell you this and that when none can or are willing, when people don't want to teach you, the Holy Spirit will teach you. When people want to please you, the Holy Spirit will tell you the truth. Hallelujah. If there is no Holy Spirit, oh, what a lukewarm church in the world today.
Hallelujah.
We thank the Holy Spirit and the move of Jesus. That's why Jesus said, it's good for you for me to go. Because if I go, then this one will come. Somebody may be watching on Facebook and maybe we're watching on television. Why Jesus have to go? Jesus can stay. He said it's good for him to go and the Holy Spirit. Is the Holy Spirit better than Jesus? Some of us will ask those questions. But this is what the Holy Spirit plays in my heart. Jesus is God. But he's limited with his flesh. When he's in Jerusalem, he's not in Nandi. When he's in Samoa, he's not in Mexico. Because he's limited by the things of the body is from Mary. It's from Mary's body.
Amen.
As I normally say that Jesus is 100% God, but also 100%
man.
He's not 50% God and 50%
man.
No, he's 100% God. And he's 100% man. He lives in this world as
100%
man. That's why he has to fast. That's why he has to read the Bible. Because the flesh have to glorify God. And the flesh will be a good example to us Christians that Jesus do it, we can also do it. Hallelujah. That's why Paul said, I can do all things because Christ in me. If Jesus conquered the world 100% man, that means you are sitting here, we can conquer the world
100%.
Hallelujah. Jesus was before he came into Mary as a baby. Well, listen, let us make man in our image and likeness. That's God, Holy Spirit, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Jesus did not start from Mary. Jesus did not start from
Bethlehem.
So that's why when you continue to celebrate Christmas, you are telling the people that Jesus is only start from the Christmas.
No,
the Christmas is gone. He did not start there. He's already sitting at the right hand side. We can remember he's coming into this world. But it's not supposed to be something that we worship. We don't worship the baby, we worship God. And the time of baby is finished. You don't walk around and showing everybody your baby picture. You always go and this is my picture when I was a baby. It's just a small occasion. And just a happy birthday, that's finished. We don't worship our birthday. We just come together and we say happy birthday to you.
And I'm gonna say na sinusunod mina kabe koko.
Hallelujah. And that's it.
What's out?
It's just something to remember. It's not something to worship.
It's not something to worship.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I hope you understand what we're trying to say. So the Holy Spirit will tell you this and that when none can or are willing. That's why in New Methodist we don't concentrate on Christmas service. Whatever you have with your family, that's it. Just remember that Jesus came as a man. Hallelujah. It's not something that we worship like a Sunday. Praise the Lord. Number two, the Holy Spirit will guard you from the desire to sin.
Because
you have the flesh. Because you have the flesh. That's why the Holy Spirit descended on Jesus and remained in Jesus. Hallelujah. Because he is the man, he's the only man that never sinned in this world. That's why he has the name above every name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. In heaven, on earth, and under the earth. Hallelujah. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. Because this man does not sin. He wants to prove to the world that you can be a holy person. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Why? Because the Holy Spirit came down and in him. That's why we need the Holy Spirit in the church. When we talk about Holy Spirit, people, they don't believe easily. Because Jesus, people can see. But Holy Spirit, nobody can see. We only see the power of the Holy Spirit. We don't see the Holy Spirit. We can see the wind that blows. We see it because of the leaves, because of the flowers. But we don't see the wind. Holy Spirit is something like that. You see the effect of the Holy Spirit. But you cannot see the Holy Spirit. You can see the effect of strong wind. You can see the effect of a cyclone. But you don't see the wind. Hallelujah. But sometimes the pictures of satellite. No, that's the picture of the cloud, not the picture of the wind. Hallelujah. And that is the picture of the cloud, not the picture of the wind. We cannot see the wind. Yeah, even the radar, even the computer cannot capture what is wind. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And number three, the Holy Spirit will keep you in the right track if you are willing. Hallelujah. Tell the person next to you, if you are willing. Oh, hallelujah. Because most of the time we are not willing for the Holy Spirit to teach us. Because our body is controlled by the physical flesh. And the lust of the flesh will lead us in this world. That's why a lot of people, they go on the wide road. Only few people walk on the narrow road. Because people don't understand the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. A lot of churches, they don't understand the work of the Holy Spirit. Even some men of God, they don't understand the work of the Holy Spirit. We need to understand the work of the Holy Spirit. Number two, this is another word. He will declare righteousness. Read together. Two, three. He will declare righteousness and abagatakila nandundun. Read together. Root 2, 3. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is your advantage that I go away. For I do not go away, the helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I will send him to you. And when he has come, he will convict the world of sin. We already talked about that. Number two. And of righteousness and of judgment. Of sin because they do not believe in me. Okay, in Fijian, my talk is only and the rest. 2, 3. Ia ni salago mai kokoya, and magatakila I bitihira na kaiburumuna na ibalaga. Kaina nudodu, kaina lewa. So we all not talk about the ibalaga. That's why it's very important when you are committing sin, you convict. I'm still on with the Holy Spirit. Ask your neighbor, are you still on with the Holy Spirit? Is your spiritual mobile on or off?
Hallelujah.
Every text, every viper, every message that will come, there will be a vibration or small sound. Hallelujah. That means your spiritual mobile is on. But if you are doing something that is not right in this world and you cannot feel it, then something is wrong. Either no power or no... no fiber, or what you call, no network.
Kamagasada ka muskani balamon lang sa sinukin daw na ito lang may ruwa sa siyang biyang hindi katsirao chiko sa sasin mo na siya pati.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Tarigo to sa siya mamay. Siya mamay. Siya mamay. Siya mamay. Hallelujah. Okay. On this work here on B, read with me, 2-3. The Holy Spirit will assist and guide you to think and walk straight.
Lalo tambay na buke iko, mo pakasama, wala ko sarap ko nunod.
Hallelujah. That means the Holy Spirit will speak with, when you talk about makasama, what part of your body you're talking about? Your mind, your brain. So the Holy Spirit communicates with your brain.
Lalo tambay buka, mo sige mo nunod mo pakasama.
He's not communicating with your hands, your fingers. He's communicating with your brain.
Kwasi ni sema manalinga mo sena mamu.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Eh? And that's why the devil wants you to drink and get drunk, so your brain is off from the network of the Holy Spirit.
Ya nabu na sa ngayon sa tebo ro mo mateni sa ro magalibo mo kuno sa marawa kina buru magayabo.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Why the world love their drinks? That's the work of the devil.
Nalaba ya bine katika na buru buru merang dumati ni tunga. Zaga ni tebo.
Big big people, big job. And the more they receive money, and oh, it's about time that we entertain ourselves, especially this time. Beach party, Christmas party, all the party. And that's why the wise men from the east, they can capture the stars. And the people in Jerusalem, they cannot capture the stars. Whenever you have the atmosphere like Jerusalem, which is party and merrymaking and songo and kalabata or kalabata. Then you cannot see the stars.
Na kalokole pakatakala ni.
The Bible says when they are away from Jerusalem, then the stars appear again.
Sambila mo Jerusalem mbasi ka dolbo.
So the stars appear to you wherever you are. It depends on the place that you are.
And ndo mo boga tshona kalokole pakatonga na boga tshu.
You in Jerusalem, you cannot see the stars.
Tshu Jerusalem simna.
When you go back to Bethlehem, which is about 7 kilometers from Jerusalem, the stars appear again.
Bethlehem mbasi ka dolbo kalokole.
From the east, the star was there.
Meno boni ko raitu.
From Bethlehem, the star was there. But in Jerusalem, the star was not there. Why? Because the atmosphere that the world is pushing you to do right now, right here. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. The Holy Spirit will assist and guide you to think and walk straight. Number two, let us read together. 2-3. The Holy Spirit will come between you and committing sin. Hallelujah. Because nobody sitting here that you can say that you can't commit sin. No, nobody is immune to that. When the Holy Spirit is not there, it will be very easy for you to commit sin. That's why we need the Holy Spirit. Jesus is sitting at the right hand side of God. But the Holy Spirit is here. When he's here in Jared Church, he's in Nasinu. He's in Nosori. He's in Nandi. He's in Texas. He's in California. He's in Australia. He's in New Zealand. He's in England. He's in Germany. Because the Holy Spirit can be every person and everywhere at one time. That's why he said, it's good for you for me to go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So that's our best friend, the Holy Spirit. He walks with us. He loved to walk with us. Hallelujah. Number three, let us read together. 2-3. The Holy Spirit encourages people of God against the lust of the flesh. So the Holy Spirit wants to walk with you. When you want to walk on the left, when you want to walk on the right, the Holy Spirit will encourage you to walk with him straight. He wants you to walk on the street called straight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Are you with us this morning? Let us move on. See. He will warn you of the judgment. Let us complete this one. 2-3. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For I do not go away, the helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I will send him to you. And when he comes, number one, he convicts the world of sin, A, and righteousness, that's B, and of judgment, that's C. Yan ni siya lang may kukuya, na makataklabi kem do, na kayo murmura, na iwal mo na, kayo nakamun do, kayo nalewa. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit will always convict you that there is a judgment. And the one is trying to trick you is already judged. See the angels, they will, the fallen angels, that means, they will don't have any chance to repent. You can repent. When you fall, you stand up again. When you walk away, you can come in again. That's the opportunity that we have. But the fallen angels, they don't have any chance. They are already judged. Lake of fire is waiting for them. That's why the evil spirit, the small one, spirit of laziness, spirit of envy, spirit of fighting, these are all going to hell. See, the chief demon is the devil. His name is Lucifer. After that, we have small demons. When you hate somebody, spirit of hate. When you jealous about somebody, that's spirit of jealousy. So all those things, their destination, H-E-L-L, hell. No chance of repentance. So the Holy Spirit already told us that the judgment already done. Okay, let us read together. 2, 3. The devil does not have any strength to save himself from this judgment. No more chance, no authority. That's why they will try their best, they'll try everything to carry a lot of God's children with them. Because they hate God of his decision, his righteousness, because they want to coup heaven. They want to take over. And nobody can take over in God. But because of pride and arrogance.
Hallelujah.
And Lucifer was the head and the chief of the angels that praise God every day and night. So out of the three archangels, Gabriel, Michael and Lucifer, he was the one well known because he is the one that cheering on God and exalting God and praising God and worshiping God. So when he was cast down, one third of the angels from heaven were cast down with him. And imagine billions and billions and billions and millions and millions of angels that they become fallen angels. Hallelujah. And their duty is to make sure that the children of God, they don't believe in the word of God. They are not in the nightclub. They are not normally on the street. They come to church. They come to your devotion. They come to your cell group. They come to your worship center. Because their front line is here. That's why when you want to go to church, there is a small fight at home. And sometimes, okay, you just go to church, I will stay home. That is duty. It's duty for you not to come to church. It's duty for you not to hear the word of God. It's a duty for you not to praise God. When you come to church, you feel lazy. Hallelujah. And you don't feel like praising, you don't feel like singing. You don't feel like clapping. That is the evil spirit. Hallelujah. Tell the person next to you, but it don't go to my mother. But it don't
go to my mother. Hallelujah.
Elni tobombota, elni budesa, elni wanda, elni wanda.
Bia lo kata kata ayer tu bitar or tu bitur ini tu bagiko.
Their only duty is to cut you off, not to feel the presence of God. That's why we always have a prayer, you know, like a warfare prayer in the church when we started. That's what the Holy Spirit plays in our heart. When the church starts, we start like that. Way back in 2002, any church service, cell group, worship center, or zone, or even combined, we must do a warfare because a lot of evil spirits, they catch us on the road. Sometimes with you, sometimes you call them. And when we sing in church, we don't feel the power of God in the church. Because they block the, you know, the network, they tend to cut off the network. Whenever you think of the spiritual warfare, think about the Bible, how the mobile works. You must have the power. You must have the network. And if you want to communicate, you must have your data. When you think of how mobile work, then you start to realize, because mobile, the Wi-Fi, you don't see it. It's there.
Hallelujah.
If you on your mobile, what we call the setting, you will catch that there is a Wi-Fi coming from the media. But because you don't have the code, you can't tap into. Because you are with a network of the Holy Spirit network, the evil spirit cannot touch because he does not have the code.
Hallelujah.
You have that code? You got a code, Pakao. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That's why I said from the beginning it's good to sit in the church and especially the Bible study. You sit here as like sitting in the classroom. Because when you sit in the Bible study, a lot of knowledge you'll fit into your mind. So you will improve how to serve God. See, the preaching only challenge you and encourage you to come here, surrender, or make a decision. That's preaching. But the Bible study will like an ABC of the Bible, like you walk with the Word of God. That's why the Bible says, go into the world. Preach the gospel. That's preaching the gospel. For those that believe, baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. And the Bible says, then teach them what I have taught you. So the teaching in the church, the preaching is out there. The teaching for the people already surrender. Hallelujah. Slap your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you should not miss teaching. Teaching is very important. Hallelujah. Number two, let us read together. 2, 3. The destiny of the devil and all his followers are already confirmed. Hallelujah. Their term is eternity. Burn in hell. And that's why the devil is working very, very hard. For a nice Christian, for a good Christian like you, to lose your faith. It's not about denomination. It's not about the name of the church. It's about God and you and heaven. All I have for you is to prosper you. And never to harm you. And to give you the future that you hope for. See, everything about God is good. Everything about God is good. Everything about your family is good. Everything about worship is good. He's a good God. Hallelujah. And our destination is heaven. Because you are already bought by the precious blood of Jesus. Jesus bought us while we were still in our mother's womb. Hallelujah. So you already belong to God. And that's why the devil is coming from the time that you are young, will continue to attack you and knock on your door. He will not approach you like devil. He will approach you with the very thing that you love the most. You love your food? He will attack you through your food. You love rugby? He will attack you through anything on rugby. Hallelujah. You love music? He'll attack you through music. So you need to understand how the devil works. Because when you know your enemy, you know the armor to fight your enemy. When you don't know your enemy, you will use all kinds of armor, the ineffective one. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Are you with me this morning? Number three, all the commotions about the different in race, religion, culture will result in zero or will be burnt in hell. Religion will not take you to heaven. Your culture, your banua, your matagal, your tokatoka will not take you to heaven. The way that you are born from your father, your mother will not take you to heaven. Your work will never take you to heaven. It's knowing Jesus that will take you to heaven. And the Holy Spirit will guide you while you're still alive, not to miss that opportunity, because the Holy Spirit is for this life, when God, Jesus, is for that life. Because your destination is heaven. Don't allow the evil spirit to take you. Are you here this morning? Are you here this morning? Before we come to the conclusion of this message, I want to challenge our life. This is one of the good lessons. And if you haven't received this lesson, you ask our media. You have your email address, give it to them. They will send it to you.
Amen.
It'll be good for you to go and read and read, and we'll assist you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. If we are giving all this lesson to the people, non new melodies, why you should not read it yourself?
Praise the Lord.
Because I believe in a few Sundays I'll be talking on this message here. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Kito tiko may Brisbane, kito tiko may Sydney, kito tiko may Griffith. Ano na kana tama tano na binakata na labi-labi ni lesson. Kasi there are some people watching now on Facebook. There are some people watching on television. They will call the headquarters. They will ask for the copy. Get your copy. It's not paid. Yeah. Just give your email address. And they will send it to you. Hallelujah. We will ask the worship team to sing one worship song this morning. And I believe this is the time for you to, open your heart to the Holy Spirit and tell the Holy Spirit, I'm here. I now know that you have reason to be here to lead me and to guide me and to show me and to convict me. Hallelujah. So let us stand together and worship God. Before we go into Holy testimonies, before we watch some items, let us worship Him. Hallelujah.
Holy Spirit,
oh, we praise your mighty name. Hallelujah.
Please don't ever leave.
You stand with me and worship Him. Glorify His name. Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, masu que eu viava lá na terceira, lá na
terceira.
Eu vi ela meter linha mu, bom na matada. Para que lá daí eu tava bonito, só tive na mão para mim.
Teach me your way.
Let us worship Him.
Don't rush, my friend. This is a time to worship Him. Let us give this time 3 minutes, 5 minutes. Let us worship Him. Hallelujah. Berani ngay robo tuku dialo. Berani ngay sarai tafti kuwa. My worship ka man na kalu.